Hello and welcome. In this presentation, I will be describing i2b2-tranSMART, the system currently being used for the Global Rare Disease Patient Registry Data Repository, or GRDR, by NIH's National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences, in conjunction with Harvard Medical School's Department of Biomedical Informatics. Many of you are probably already aware of, and perhaps have even used, i2b2. Or Informatics for Integrating Biology in the Bedside, a scalable informatics framework designed primarily for translational research. The creation of i2b2 was led by Isaac Kohani and is in production in more than 130 universities and hospitals worldwide. TranSMART is an application layer to i2b2. It allows all of the functionality of i2b2, plus the ability to perform complex statistical analysis, load data using a simple Excel spreadsheet, and the ability to integrate omics and additional phenotype data from multiple sources. The primary objectives of i2b2-tranSMART are the integration of clinical, biological, and omics data, including such data as genomic test results, in one place, and the generation of hypotheses by investigators interested in using the data for their research. This graphic illustrates how i2b2 and TranSMART work together to create a mechanism through which researchers can generate hypotheses and select cohorts for further study. The information on the left illustrates the data that is gathered by i2b2 from the electronic health record. TranSMART adds statistical analysis tools and the ability to easily load data from multiple sources, such as omics data, as illustrated on the right. Sources of data for i2b2-tranSMART can include any patient-level data. For instance, patient consents, clinical records, registries, patient-reported outcomes such as from questionnaires, biobank information, environmental data, EEG or neuroimaging results, genome sequencing data and expression arrays, and countless other data that may be available on a patient population. Google Maps is a good analogy of the capabilities of i2b2-tranSMART. Google Maps integrates a variety of data into one searchable system. Transportation, such as roads and highways, structures and points of interest, current traffic jams, census tracts, and postal codes are all examples of data that are included in Google Maps. i2b2-tranSMART answers the need to be able to do this with patient data. This allows for increased research, hypotheses, and data accessibility. This illustration is an example of one use for i2b2-tranSMART. In this example, the data that was included incorporated genomic data from genetic testing, EHR data such as lab values, ICD-9 codes, and medications with the use of i2b2, and clinical notes using CTAKE's natural language processing, data from the biobank regarding availability of samples, and patient consents for research. This combined data could then be searched by investigators in order to generate hypotheses for potential research and for high-throughput statistical analysis. TranSMART is not the only tool that utilizes i2b2. This diagram illustrates the i2b2 world, so to speak. i2b2 is the platform used with such tools as Shrine, SMART, and TranSMART. i2b2 is the central patient-level database model for these tools. For this phase of GRDR, i2b2-tranSMART will be set up on a secured Amazon cloud, which will allow greater accessibility for investigators while still maintaining security for the information contained in the GRDR. Data from 17 participating rare disease registries will then be loaded and integrated. Finally, investigator requests for access to data will be managed accordingly. Level 1 access provides investigators with aggregate data only. No IRB approval is required for this access. Level 2 access, however, provides patient-level data. For this level, an approved IRB protocol must be in place by the investigator. I will now show you a live demo of the GRDR i2b2-tranSMART application. For this demo, you will see Level 1 data access, or aggregate counts only. We are going to look at a couple of use cases using the GRDR i2b2-tranSMART user interface. Let's specifically look at the intracranial hypertension registry. Intracranial hypertension is a neurological disorder in which cerebrospinal fluid pressure within the skull is too high. For the first use case, let's say that you wanted to search whether there was an association between gender and idiopathic intracranial hypertension. You'd want to look only at those with a primary diagnosis rather than a secondary or undetermined diagnosis. So under intracranial hypertension, disease status, we find diagnosis, we'll drag and drop primary into subset 1, and secondary as well as undetermined into subset 2, and we'll generate summary statistics. From here, we'll go under demographic data, patient, and we'll find the variable for sex. We'll drag and drop this variable to determine the association with gender. A chi-squared analysis is performed and a p-value is generated, and you can see from these results that they're significant at a 95% confidence level. Now let's say you wanted to know if there was an association between being overweight and a primary diagnosis of idiopathic intracranial hypertension among females. We'll go back to the subset selection, and we'll drag and drop female into each subset. And generate summary statistics. From here, we'll drag and drop the variable of weight at time of diagnosis. A t-test is performed and a p-value is generated, and you can see that these results are also significant. And for the sake of illustrating the accuracy of these results, both of these use cases were demonstrated in studies by Durkin et al. And Hanley et al. Now let's turn our attention to the International Pachyonychia Congenita Research Registry. So we'll go back to the subset selection, delete our previous entries, minimize intracranial hypertension registry, and go into the International Pachyonychia Congenita Research Registry. Pachyonychia congenita is an ultra-rare genetic disorder that causes skin cells to be extremely fragile. For this use case, we'll try to replicate the study done by Sponhurst et al. That found that patients with a mutation in KRT6A have more extensive disease compared with patients who have mutations in KRT16. So our question becomes, do pachyonychia patients with different mutations have different phenotypes? Under clinical data, diagnosis, we find mutation in the gene for keratin. We'll drag and drop PCK6A into subset 1 and PCK16 into subset 2, and we'll generate summary statistics. From here, we can drag and drop phenotypes to see the difference in manifestation between the two subsets. So we'll go into physical findings, and these are organized by location. Let's first look at number of thickened fingernails. So we'll go into fingernails, lesions, and we'll drag and drop number of thickened fingernails at this time. And you can see that after a t-test is performed and the p-value indicates that the results are significant. Now let's look at thickened white skin in mouth as a phenotype. So we'll go down to mouth, tongue, and teeth, lesion, thickened white skin in mouth, and we'll drag and drop. That analysis comes out at the top of the page, and the p-value indicates that the results are significant. Next, we'll look at having cysts or growths as a phenotype. So we'll go under skin, lesion, having cysts or growths, drag and drop, and that analysis also indicates a statistically significant result. Now let's try having follicular hyperkeratosis. That analysis comes out, and you can also see that the p-value is significant. So you can see that these results support the findings of the study that having a mutation in K6A leads to a more severe phenotype. If you'd like to try the i2b2-tranSMART user interface yourself, you can do so on our publicly available i2b2-tranSMART application using data from the National Health and Nutrition Examination Survey, or NHANES, login and password demo. If you'd like to learn more about GRDR and i2b2-tranSMART, you can visit the websites for GRDR, Harvard Medical School's Department of Biomedical Informatics, Picture, the parent project of GRDR, and the AVIAC Lab website. Thank you.